Okay, I have had a video request by several people, and I do read all of y'all's comments, and I always appreciate every one of you that comments and asks me questions or suggests videos. This is a regular old ammo can, and I'm going to show you how to go from this right here, a regular ammo can, to this, which some of y'all probably recognize as my wood stove for my van. It's in the back window. But I'm going to show you how I went from the ammo can to the stove, and hopefully it will help somebody maybe build one. I'm going to try to do a little build video and build out that other one, and you know, try to show you what I did, and there's probably improvements that you could do to make it better. But anyway, let's get started. First off, what all do you need? Of course, to make an ammo can stove, you need the ammo can. Kind of goes without saying. You need a piece of pipe for your flue. It will go right here. You need a hole saw that matches up pretty well with the pipe right there. Actually, I've lost the part that goes in the top of this, so I welded this other one in. I'm hoping it will last. But anyway, I guess you work with what you got. You will need some fire rope, like the type of rope that goes into a fireplace, because inside here, the seal that goes around here is rubber, and that will catch on fire. It'll burn, so you have to remove that. And after you remove that, you lose your seal. So you have to put some fire rope in. It's available at, I've got that in the hardware store. And you just kind of wrap it around on the inside there. I'll show you that part. You need an assortment of drill bits. You know, I just got all my drill bits out. You need some pieces of pipe. I mean, you can do this however you want for the legs, but I'm going to take these pieces of pipe and I'm going to weld them onto the bottom of the ammo can so that they will be my legs. You're also going to need another piece of metal for the door, because when you cut out this end right here, the part you cut out is going to be smaller than the part, you know, than the hole. So you need something that will seal over the hole, so here you go. It's not exactly straight, but anyway, it's a piece of metal. Of course, you'll need a drill and a grinder. Oh yeah, you need a hinge. It's the only hinge that I had laying around, so I guess this is the one we're going to be using. It would be better to have a flat hinge, but like I said, that's what we got. It's what we're going to use. You might need to do some measuring, some marking. Just have stuff ready for that. What would come in handy but is not exactly required is a welder that is very handy in this. I just weld everything together, but you can screw everything together. One thing is with the pipe, that or the flue or chimney, whatever you want to call it, that comes out of here. If you don't have a welder and you just drill that out and try to weld around it, try to seal around it somehow, you're not going to be able to seal it up unless you can weld around it. But one thing you can do, like on this old ammo can over here, or ammo can stove over here, I took a exhaust pipe, same kind of exhaust pipe, but it had the flange on it, and I welded the flange to it. But you could take these screws out and just screw it down into the top of the ammo can. So this out, and as you can see it right in here, you've got a piece of metal that's actually bent over onto the seal holding it in. So what you do, get in there with a screwdriver. Once you get a good corner of it off, it should pretty much peel out. Just got to get that corner peeled up or you'll never get it out of there. I tried on the last one for a while trying to get it out of there. Okay, that is your rubber seal. We do not need that anymore. What we need is this, the rope. It all the way around. To where it can seal up. You don't want that smoke getting out. I could have got the other size. They had two sizes of rope. I could have got the bigger one, but see how that feels. The way that you know that if it's sealed up or not, if the can rattles, it didn't seal up. It does not rattle. You can shake it, and it does not rattle. It's got to fit tightly. If it doesn't fit tightly, you're going to have smoke coming out around the seam. You don't want that. Next, this handle has to be removed. Okay, in order to remove our handle, we're going to use our trusty grinder. And if you're going to have sparks flying, try to think of safety because you've only got two eyeballs. Here you go. Okay, there's your handle. You could actually use that for something else if you wanted to. And get these the rest of the way off of here. Okay, now, you want to go on this end for your chimney because you're going to want your door on this side where you can cut all this out. You've already got all this mess on this side, so this needs to be the back of the stove. Now, one good part about having all this still intact, when you go to clean your stove out, all you got to do, pop that open, and there you go. Now what we're going to do is we're going to figure out how far back we're going to want it. I would say a about there should be pretty good. You want it toward the back. From the end of there to there, we'll put it right on 3 inches to the center. I'll put the whole thing back on here. That way you have the box to help stabilize while I'm drilling the hole. Now you'll figure out where it goes that way. Then measure across this way at 6 inches, 3 inches by 3 inches. Okay. And I suppose X marks the spot. So now we have our friend the drill. Up the pipe a little bit, grinding me out a spot for my welding clamp, and here we go. Put it in there. Actually, when I grinded this out a little bit, or grinded this off to clean it, it actually made it fit tighter. So, that's where it actually just kind of sits there. So, here we go. I'm going to turn it down a little. Okay, so there is our exhaust welded in. It's not going to go nowhere. Now, next, we need to work on our door. Just going to take this part off. You want the end, of course, with the hinge on it, right here. And what you're going to want to do, raise y'all up a little bit, maybe bring you a little closer. What you're going to want to do is you're going to want to figure out what size of door you want. You can pretty much use the whole front. So about a half inch down. We'll just go a half inch in from every direction. Except, okay. Except for the bottom. On the bottom, we're going to go all the way down. All the way down to here. Might leave just a hair bit of a lip, not much. But the reason for that is it makes it easier to clean the ashes out. Once you burned your wood or whatever. Okay. Here. Leave just a small lip on the bottom, not much. Okay, that's going to be the door right there. This part, of course, gets cut out. This part, it seems like that would be the perfect door, but it's not because it's where it's cut out, it won't seal. So we're going to take this other piece of metal right here, find the straightest side we can. Well, let's see what. Yeah, we'll just do it like that. It won't be perfect, but my other one is not perfect either, and it works fine. Okay, I got that marked. Just gotta cut that out. Same deal once again. Okay, here you go. Here's your door. Now, you need a hinge. Like I said, it would be a lot better to have a better hinge than this. This is not a very good hinge, but it's what I got, like I said. It's also brass. Actually, I think it's what I used on the other one, is one like this. That's all I had at the time. You know, there's kind of a theme with my projects. I use whatever I got. Okay, you can see that when that closes, it actually tries to push itself back open. That means it's tight enough that it's going to seal. It'll seal pretty good. I mean, it would still leak out of here a little bit, but it's not that big. This fits in here. And this, which is kind of hot, will go here. Just like that. Needs to be loose enough that it can move. I was trying to pull it too tight. Okay, I'll see if that works. Well, yeah. Now, what else do you need in the front? You need some sort of air, some sort of thing to close the air off with. And I'm thinking I may just try to use this little, I don't have a window to put in there like I did on mine, but so I can use all this room that I want. So I think what I'm going to do, I'm going to put this right there. Let me clean it up a little. Right there. I'm gonna bend that. It's just a little piece right there. Then I mean, you can make this part any way you want. All this is a way to let air get into the fire. I'll probably put it down about right there. Thank you. I'm going to try this. I don't know how good it's going to work or if it's going to work. But this is a different way to do it anyway. I made a slit all the way across here, drilled holes in it, and then made it to where it slides like this. But I'm going to try, this time I'm going to try it a little different. Okay. Now, with this, this should work. When you turn this little wheel, well, you loosen it up just a little more. I can add some more holes, but this gives you the idea. See, that is completely sealed off, and that's all the way open. Now, if you put holes all the way around, it would be better, but you have to leave enough space between for the holes to have nothing behind them, you know. But that will work. I may put one more over on this side. Okay, next thing will be the legs. I'm going to do them a little different than I did mine on the other one. I'm going to put them on the very bottom, like this. All four of them, like that. Okay, those are welded on. And extra middle hanging around. But as you can see now, it will stand up by itself. Okay, I guess we could get rid of this one screw that's sticking out right here. Okay, now one more thing we need. We need a grate in here. Got some of this stainless steel here. And I had been using it in my fire pit, but I think it'll do a lot better for this. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to leave a little bit of overhang, like about that much. And let's, I don't know if I'll even be able to mark this. I can kind of see that. I wanted it to stick out on both sides is because I'm going to bend these up or down, whichever way you want to think about it. This will be my grate for the logs to sit on. About that much. And see, this way it holds itself off of the bottom just a little bit to let air get under it. And it'll let it burn better. Because of the screws, I've got to put it in this way first. something there. There we go. Okay. Now, if you look, you can see that there is an area under here where the air can come in and go under here, come up through your wood, that way it can burn better. Now when you put the top on, like this, close all that down, and I did that one part wrong. Yep, I sure did. Chimney's on the wrong end. Pay attention, put it on the one opposite the hinges. Don't be like me. But anyway, I suppose it would still work, but I wanted it back there and wasn't really thinking. So yeah, see, it's easy to make mistakes on this stuff. But it will work. Let me get you off of the... Okay, well, it still will be fine. I would like to, I may end up trying to seal this hole up and put it back here at some point, but anyway, that's a good note for y'all when you make one. Make sure you put the pipe opposite of the hinge. I was thinking opposite of this thing, so yeah, or I guess I could say I wasn't thinking. Okay, now, I know some of y'all have had a question about the gas setup that I had, because you could, in the one in the van, you can burn either gas or wood. This one, right here, will only burn wood. It does look a lot better with the window in it. I do like, if you can find an old kerosene heater, an old round kerosene heater, that has got the window in it, like this right here, you know, you'll be able to see your fire burning. Okay, now the other thing that people have been curious about, and if you do this, you're doing it at your own risk, because it's probably not the best of ideas. It does come in awfully handy, and I haven't had any troubles with it or anything like that. See if I can get some of this ash out of your way so you can see. Yeah, you can see the little copper pipe back in there. All that is just... Actually, I have another piece right here. And actually, this is the first one that I tried to make. Okay, I took a piece of copper pipe and took a hammer and kept bending the end of it over like that until it was sealed on the end, which it wouldn't really matter if it leaked out a little bit, because there would just be a little fire coming out of it, and it's all inside there anyway. Because I went all the way across, drilling holes. You can see the holes drilled ever so often in it. Like right there, all the way back to here. And all I did was I drilled a hole in the side of the can and had to put this back in there like that. So this is actually sitting back. It's about in the middle, about right here. And this end of the copper is just plumbed into a hose. Like I said, you don't want to leave this kind of a setup unattended. This would be for like lighting it or something like that. This is a torch tip. I took the very tip part off. The tip of it just screws off. And you can stick this back in the hose, and it will keep all the, you know, all the propane going through the hose. You just turn your propane on, light the propane flame inside here, and as it's burning, you know, the propane will be coming out of these little holes like that, and you'll just stick your lighter by these holes very carefully. And then, well, what you do is you put your lighter in there first. Use one of those long barbecue lighters. Then turn your gas on real slow. Once it lights, then you'll have the fire burning in here. You put your wood in here and it will start your fire. Or you can, I've used it to heat with, but it doesn't have a regulator and it doesn't have a thermocouple. That's two things you need when you're running gas. So if you do this modification, that's, you're doing that at your own risk. I would advise having a thermocouple set up and all that kind of stuff in there, which I don't have. So you would never want to leave this setup running without sitting and watching it. But as far as the wood part goes, this one will burn wood just fine. If your fire is too high, I tightened that back up, I guess, didn't I? If your fire is too high, close off the air. You want to let it breathe a little bit, but it doesn't need to be wide open all the time. In fact, in my van, I cannot keep the stove open at all. I've got to pretty much almost choke it all the way down or it will run me out. I have to end up opening windows up on the van. I mean, both front windows all the way down, what I'm talking about. So, I mean, if in colder climates, yeah, you would probably want to run it wide open, but the coldest I've had that stove in was about 30 degrees, and, you know, it did so well that it was too much. That is the build. I mean, that's how to build an ammo can stove. This can be used for camping. You don't have to use this in a van or a vehicle. Oh, yeah, you can actually set stuff up here and cook on it, which, like I said, this should be back here, but you get the idea. You can set stuff up here and cook. But anyway, that's my little ammo can stove build video, and I think that's gonna about do it. Thank you for watching. Have any questions, ask me in the comments, and if you want to get updates on my videos as they come in, or get notifications, down right below the video where it says subscribe, if you are subscribed to me, ring that little bell right beside the subscribed where it says subscribed, and you'll get notifications anytime I put up a new video. So, well, thank you for watching. I'll see y'all next time.